chest of him, right? So put under the skin. Don't worry about it right now. Throw them into the sea. You got to care about the mental health. You know, your party, Kasitaji's story. He was talking about how the world seems better than when the world is. When you must have finished from a vendor. For me, I was a vendor. I will tell the people who you know they cannot do my story. I was a vendor in my first year in the university. So in my first year in Makerere University, I used to vendor, I used to vend milk. I was a supplier for milk in the university. Those who were there in that time, they would remember. They remember that. And then I used to have a side business. I used to say secondhand shoes in the Uno market. So I know what it means. So I know how you can incubate yourself in business and graduate into a huge businessman. Had I not been in politics, I would be competing in the civility of the Uganda.
Oh really? So you're sacrificing?
So I went into politics. But what do I mean to say? These vendors, keeping vendors on the street, would be very risky. It was, they were, first of all, they were risking their business because they were being harassed by, not being harassed anyway. The law enforcement officers would grab their whole capital in his life at any time. You would dodge them for a whole month. The second month, third month, they will catch up with you, take off all your capital you have in your life. Yeah. Then you lose it. So many people were losing. Secondly, it's not healthy. If a city is growing, you don't need vendors on the street, in the road. But if we develop this kind of markets, which are modern, it begins from a store. From a store, you will even, these are the businesses we are incubating that will become its own arcade. If you go and ask him to be his story, he will tell you that he never owned that. Ask him for this.
He came with $25,000.
Ask him, this is Tripathi I'm talking about, who is working more. Talk about this, my brother and my friend Shumira. All of them will tell you their story that actually at one time they were being Cheyo. They did not have money to do anything. But slowly, they made their business, incubated their business, graduated to another level. So these vendors, we are telling them, go to your Mukmudara way.
Right.
Own your own store. Right. From your own store, you will own it. Because we are now want them to graduate from just what Kayondo was talking about, from data fees to ownership. We come from ownership of a single store. We want these people to build their own shops and their own arcades. This is the way to go. This is the way we can develop our own Ugandan. This is the only way we can develop the youth, the ladies, women who have been doing this vending. For heaven's sake, you find people are cooking on the street.
Right.
This is not healthy. First of all, they are even risking their lives. Sometimes you find they have their children. Now these are the same. At the end of the day, the kind of children they are growing with, they turn out to be street children. And then you ask, where are these street children coming from? Kunde, they are coming from these street vendors.
Right.
Live on the street, grow on the street. When you die, they take you to the public mortuary. Nobody claims your body. You are just dumped anyway. We want these people to grow responsibly, incubate their business, have a city which is very well organized, so that when Kasita has his shop, there's nobody who's crowding his entrance. So that we are moving in the city.
Okay.
You move with your head high,
right,
knowing that I'm living in a modern city of Kampala. Right. So we are not harassing these workers.
Right.
We are actually trying to help them to have their responsible citizens, become businessmen, nurture their business, invest their business. And in any case, you know, we are doing all of the innovations to make sure that even where we go in the market, we are trying to have a pool of money where they can borrow startup capital through circles. Those who don't have circles like the youth, we are investing startup capital by it has been provided the budget for the 4 billion shillings, for the 5 billion shillings, so that they inspect their business. So the plan, okay, we have the plan for them, and we mean very well. We only need the people to own up so that we move together
right.
and graduate together into these areas of growth.
Okay. I think this time we should begin with very briefly, one of the managers, before we move forward. What's the position of the Kampala Upper Place? Owned by one man, and traders have been complaining. Seems to have been ring-fenced for certain.
I think maybe the minister could have reached in Kampala. He was commissioning a number to him in Gandoni, in Barara there, that area.
So no more homes
we in want, No, exactly. No more homes. Why should the, for heaven's sake, transport a home? Who, on, what?
From
Barara, 300 kilometers. You just transport meat, which is presented. For heaven's sake, why should we be exporting cows to Sudan, to Congo? We should be exporting meat, because meat people actually, in any case, it is packaged. We should be exporting this thing. Actually, I am to Parliament the other day, passing and increase the taxes. We need to begin a tannery industry so that this hides and skin we turn into leather. We make processed leather. These hooves, we turn them into, these horns, we turn them into buttons. And anybody who is doubting that, you can go into these cottage industries around Kampala. They are all doing that. So we want to add value addition, not to have a cow from Ankole or Teso or where it comes with near the agenda. Offals, then you Kampala has nowhere to dump them, and yet they are supposed to remain in Mbarara and be thrown into the Rutoke.
Okay.
Here there is no Rutoke where you can throw that kind of thing. It adds the problem to the sewer in the town. So we want to live in a modern country and a modern country.
And of course I've always wondered why you really have to be in this area. Mr. Kanyondo, talk to us about the selection of the candidates. This glorious class. How will the people be selected?
The selection
the people to own them.
To own the salt, the what?
Yes.
Since here they are, well, because they already have a plan, I don't know how they hatch it and how they have developed up this level. Maybe there is a system which has already been
I can hear that in the hall.
But yes. What I think, because they have been already, these markets have been existing, they have been ongoing. I believe they were those who were the
city
tenants. Yes,
but they're much bigger than they could take. They should be much bigger. So how do you select to come?
Who should be part of the game?
Yes,
let me explain.
Very briefly.
First of all, these are vendors. They are going to own these things. And where there are extra spaces that they cannot occupy, for example, where they get that plan.
Have you ever get that?
No. Like on the other plan, they can somewhere like in Owino. They would find four floors and the rest upper floors are for renting to other people.
So the ownership is core.
To generate income among themselves. I think I could explain more.
Yeah, it's not a matter of selection. When government policy came in place for the sitting vendors and sitting tenants taking over the development of those areas, the market vendors in Nakasero market and Senkaritu Bele and Seka market, and I believe in other markets which are not in Kampala, they formed their association.
Which are existing?
Yes. And then all the people in this market registered. So that it is not a matter of selection.
It already exists. It's a cut and dry.
So the trick was, just because those people were already in the market,
they registered
themselves and they agreed on how much money to pay in order to raise the premium and the money for ground rent.
And the land ownership?
The land ownership will be the
government provide money to pay for land.
Yes, because they will be granted a lease.
Talk to us about these vendors from the streets. How much of a security threat were they?
Oh. That was much of a security threat because that one caused a lot of confusion in the city. But at the same time, before I even talk about that, when you look at the people who are vending on the street, there were no facilities, like sanitary facilities. So what happened, what will happen to them when they're on the street, you know, when they're called? So that one also created a lot of sanitary issues and problems. But when you talk about the security issues, we have a lot of problems.
Let's go to the issue of sanitation, but the city is going to get more people. NSS has been giving a huge complex on the other side. And other developments, more people about companies, what do they do in terms of sanitation? You seem to have heard that.
They come into the city that we have planned for them.
Oh, when they come?
Yes, no, we are going to KCCA. KCCA is not behaving like KCC. There is going to be a planning of that one is going to do a lot of planning. Now, taking the vendors off the streets is our security issue. Let me talk about that one, because the people will be congested, and then they will bring just a few items under the radar, and then if there was any call, like walk to work, they will just join very easily because they were there with very few items, and at the same time, when the place is congested like that, it creates a situation where even people. You never know, you cannot even tell who is the criminal walking and who is not. And at the same time, inconvenience is not what you are walking on the street. And if there was anything like terrorist activities with that kind of congestion, yes, it would be a very, very easy target.
Maybe you talk about the point of the crowd, because I'm in cities that are much more crowded than our own country. Let me talk about that. This is Dr. Marie, one tonight. You can call him 0484-111-0312-260-290-0312-261-312.
Yeah, in fact, for us in the business, in the shops and in our kids, we had a very good story. Because you can't imagine, how do we do our decisions? We do them. So people, instead of window shopping, they put this thing for mattress standard.
And on the
yes, on the veranda there is full of mangoes, you have oranges, you have onions, name it. And they would be customers, the prospective customers would be pushed in the road.
They are turned away.
Because even the people are using the same road. Now the veranda is occupied by these vendors, and you can think how to do that saving at all. Now, if you look at the major complainants about the infection of the vendors, some of them are actually pickpocketers. They have lost business.
They're now
unemployed. They are because they want for them they eat the confusion. They want that type of spending and that slow for the human traffic, they will always exploit those taxes and maybe pickpocket.
How about the border? Border?
Now, the border,
we love the border piece.
Borders, I think, Capital Authority have a plan, and I think if they can actually regulate the border borders, I think it will be a very good idea because they need to get the market exploited for agents, not starting anywhere. Even if they see your vehicle in a space for vehicle parking.
And they need to be told to drive on the level. They need to be told that in this
you
car
you can get driving license, okay. Which they don't have.
Good evening, sir. Your name?
I'm calling from Kingston, Plaza.
Right.
I want to contribute. Thank you for the minister, plus the resident commissioner, the Madame Wanguzi, plus our business college. The minister, my concerns about the PPP. Because we know guys, some guys in government are not genuine, some of them are not honest. The plan is good, public-private partnership. But even the business community is also not good. So how are you going to do that? Because you look at Nakawa, the vendors, they were given the opportunity to grow that market. 20 years back, but it hasn't yet been completed. So to me, I think you have to do a lot because Ugandans and even foreigners, they are not, some of them are dishonest. Another issue the minister should talk about the tax part, because that building is very, bad shape, it's very deadly position. And
very interesting observation there. Spectrum, hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir, your name?
Yes, my name is Anthony.
Anthony.
Yeah. Mine is directed to the minister. I live in Nyeri. And that, everybody knows, is supposed to be a residential area. But every other day, all kinds of bars come down. They are not there, they are reckless. We raise this matter to the community authority. Well, as we talk about planning, we will see things going on the ground that seems to be running in the opposite direction. No comment to me.
Thank you. Yes, your name, sir?
My name is Mbore.
Yes, sir.
I greet the Honorable Minister and the RDC Councillor and the Kasita gentleman. First of all, I want to thank the government. That is now for people's program, which me and other people have been hearing for. And I'm really happy to see the minister now for monitoring, that is Honorable Kenya, is the one actually trying to monitor and see ahead that okay. For
the question, sir? Okay.
You know, the main. And NRMO.
Yeah. Okay. Can you ask a straight question? Okay.
But most people have diverted from that. They have become more Catholic instead of transforming the people.
Right.
And that is my biggest problem now with my colleagues. But I also want to explore RDC. RDC, thank you. You didn't harass the teachers and the maybe for that.
Okay. Maybe you visit her with a few flowers or something. Spectrum, hello? Okay, let's get back to the Honorable Minister.
I see the question I always directed to you, and this is very good.
Sure.
AM, in fact, rather says PPP, dishonest staff, dishonest government people, dishonest businessmen, dishonest everybody. Definitely, this is something that we must fight off. And the chairman for Kasita, for example, accuses me that the dishonest in business does not make business grow at all. The people, for example, I know Ugandans, including myself, by the way, who have so many slots for jobs that they cannot fill those jobs because they fear that if you put there somebody to steal it. You have an opportunity of expanding the shops, two shops, but you know that if you open another shop and you put there somebody to steal it. So we need to build a culture of honesty amongst Ugandans. We need a culture in Uganda of moral and integrity, build the moral and integrity of Uganda. Once we build that, then to even be easy for us to fight corruption, because people will love their country and they will love their job, and the just issue of dishonesty will not be there. I can assure you, this issue of honesty, if we are talking about honesty, you in no country will develop when you are very dishonest. We have reached into e-commerce, electronic commerce.
Yes.
Where you sit in your office, send the money, wire the money, and you send the goods. So if you are not honest, how would you come to this kind of business? So this issue of public policy, private-public partnership, it's also based on those values. These are values that we must retrain all of us. And this is something that we shall need to teach the church, the what, the religious, all of us to do this. So this is not a very big problem in as far as I'm concerned. And then he was talking about to hold tax that is somehow
it's
congested. Of course, in a modern way, we are now. I think this is where we are moving, and we all need to embrace this. Plan for this country, for this city, and all the cities and all towns in Uganda, so that we develop public transport. People should be discouraged to drive their vehicles in town, but people should be motivated to say, why do I have to drive in town anyway? Because if you know that you are living in Geyogere, you are going to board a bus and it will just drop you at city center, you move few meters to your shop or your running. So you find it driving your vehicle is an inconvenience. And in so doing, you discongest the city. So the issue is to plan for a well-managed, a well public transport system network. Why should we plan for a tax park
where taxes are going to park. They shouldn't be parking in town at all.
So your next thing,
the buses should be coming, or taxes should be, you should be just on the road.
Absolutely.
Driving, come in town, in and out. We should not even allow you to park your bus or your taxi in the city at all. Even, by the way, a private car. Perfect. So that's why we're even thinking of developing the railway system, the railway system network, so that people are living in Geogerere, Mukono, wherever you are. You don't need to use even you live in Jinja, you are working in Kampala.
Jump on the train.
You live in Masaka, you work in Kampala. You live with Gok, a railway network, whereby you live in Mbarara, and you are working in Kampala. In the morning, jump on the train. This is the modern
way. Talk about high-speed trains.
Exactly.
Because they don't
go away. And that is where our plans are moving, by the way. When I was talking about the petrol dollar,
yes.
This is where we are going.
Okay.
To plan for this country, so that if I'm going to cover, I take 2 hours, just jump on the railway network.
Because you have to pray for
it. It sounds a big dream, but the reality, I can assure you.
High-speed trains don't make too much money.
Anthony Mullins is talking about Munyonyo, which was planned as a residential area. Anthony Mullins, you really need to talk even about the Kororos, the Bukorobis. These are all city suburbs that were originally planned as
residential
area. The planning function of the city had more rest done. So we need and that's why I'm calling for everybody to embrace the new leadership of Kampala City Council Authority under the wisdom and leadership
of the Lord Mayor
of Jennifer Musisi, and with my Kapakumba, who is the Vice of Presidency. Of course, we all report to the President.
Right.
So we are all now making a U-turn, and I'm calling upon my brother, the Lord Mayor. He should now see things differently.
Okay.
We need to see things in another mirror of politicking or what, because now the times have changed now.
Yes.
The times have changed that we need to see things differently.
Right.
It's not about allowing a bar mushrooming everywhere.
Okay.
You find, like, for example, he's right in Munyonyo. I live in that part of the
city.
This is somewhere where you build a very nice residential area. A residential house in a residential area. You wake up in the morning, you find they have started the Bisubi there.
All right.
The same thing is happening in Kororo. In Kororo, I have had complaints from the ambassadors who were staying there, but they are now having noise pollution from the neighborhood. So this Bugoro, the same story. So we need to have a city which is very well planned. We have a designated areas for bars, for discos, for shops, for even the skyrise buildings.
Right.
We should know where to put skyscrapers and where not skyscrapers.
Okay.
For Wele, he was doing a complimentary thank you, Wele. But again, Wele needs to, I think he was appreciating Madame ICZ
because of the
resolve. Okay. Make sure that our children are taught very well, because I know we have problems. I know Wele, he was involved very much with teachers. We are very committed to see that the teachers get a good remuneration.
Okay.
But in the meantime, when we are grappling, see where we can save money and accommodate them, at least our children who are the future of this country should not be academically malnutrition. They should not suffer from academic malnutrition. Our teachers should get into the classes,
right,
the children, because they are the future of this country.
Correct. And of course, most of the questions were directed at you, but very briefly, before I come to the second door. Madam Mwanguzi, 20 years in Nakawa market, things have not happened. Very briefly.
In Nakawa market?
Well, that's what I am saying.
Yeah, Nakawa market, there have been wrangles. We were trying to analyze why is it that things were allowed to go down like that, so that there were accumulated things and whatnot. Now, it is just a pity that things were allowed to go that far. But now with the new system, the new status of Kampala, Kampala Capital City Authority, and with the commitment of the executive director and her team, things are going to be better. Because it was the association, the company that was running the market, but now it has gone back to KCCA to run it. and afterwards, after they have sorted out whatever is supposed to be sorted out, then the vendors themselves will take over.
Mr. Kayanda,
in fact, all the questions were directed to the minister, but I just have two comments. One, the moral decay, which we are hitherto experiencing. I think it starts right from the way we are brought up, right? Because school children have started cheating examinations, and it is from there farmers are also cheating. You find that somebody has been copied, but we put stones in the copy so that it can weigh more. So I think we need to address. I think we already have a minute of integrity and ethics. I think that's where we need
family to
then, yes, even family values. People do have houses, not families these days, and it is a very big problem. And finally, about the condition effects, definitely, I think in the short term, capital authority should look at removing those roads which are packed in that.
Even the old park, we should have a huge wall.
Yes, we can have a
very
we don't need a tax
park
within the city.
Very much. Thank you,
Dr. Thank you, Edmund.
Honorable Henry Banyan, the statements of the
and thank you, Alice, for the kind of
work. Thank you for the Edmund. Up next is the next one.
Thank you.